week with the introduction of... Who knows what's going to happen this week? My fans, Chris Cruz, along with the greatest tag team wrestler of this generation. It's Stan Lane and Stan. We are still reeling from the introduction, not only of Mr. Ted DiBiase as the commissioner, but of Dan Severn, the beast, who's going for the WXO championship.
The reviews are rolling in from last week. People love what we're trying to do here because they understand it. Taking it back a little bit to the old days, but adding some brand new stuff as well. And as you said, Chris Cruz, all kind of things are breaking loose here.
And not only that, but something never seen before here on Pro Wrestling in America. We're going to take you to the world-famous Egg Dome in Tokyo. And I got to tell you, Bart Gunn and Johnny Ace, it's going to be great action.
I spent 5 weeks over there in Japan. I'll tell you, they really get down over there. You got to be double tough to go over there.
All right, as we said, a great hour ahead for you right here on WXO Wrestling. And let's take you down to the ring because we're going to begin with a big man, Al Greene, on WXO.
Singles competition headed our way on WXO. Al Greene, the man who challenged Dan Severn last week, is set for competition.
That's my team, Chris Nelson, and I have to tell you, as excited as we are about seeing Big Al Greene back, we are really excited about going to the Egg Dome in Tokyo, where you, Stan Lane, have wrestled a number of times.
Well, I've been there many times. I wrestled against Fujinami for the World Junior Heavyweight title many years ago in front of a packed crowd, and the fans are not real loud over there the way that they are here. I prefer them here, but they just sit there, and they appreciate a good stiff match over there, and believe you me, it is stiff.
And now a man who began his career tagging with Kevin Nash of the Outsiders and spent some time as the one half of the Wrecking Crew. He's 6'1", 260 pounds. He's from right here in Tampa. He's been wrestling 11, count him, 11 years. But Al Greene, all his weight, all his might, all his power, all his experience, didn't do him any good against Dan Severn. He's got something to say apparently now, Stan. Maybe the fans have something to say to him.
What's up with the mask? It's Al Greene.
Right, good point.
I can stand here all night if you people don't shut your faces.
Well, that got a reaction. Yeah. Not the one he was hoping for.
They're not shutting theirs, but he wants to cover his.
Spit it out. Spit it out. Apparently he...
I just want all you low-budget rednecks to understand one thing. It doesn't matter to me if you're some shoot fighter, if you're some karate, if you're a boxer. Just remember one thing.
I think what he's remembering is last week.
My name is Al Greene.
All right. You said it.
I am the baddest man in the WXO wrestling.
Well, he looked a little green last week when he had that ankle lock on, didn't he?
That's a very good point. I think Al Greene is still suffering some assaults on his reputation because I don't know about you, but I thought I saw a very quick tap out when the Beast and Severn put that ankle lock on Al Greene.
Tap out. Al Greene was playing a wipeout on the canvas.
That's a very good point. Classy Chris Nelson has an opportunity to really make a career-enhancing move here by defeating Al Greene. Lord Elbow tie-up now, and the powerful 260-pound Al Greene shoves Nelson back with authority and with ease.
Well, I look for Al Greene to make an example of this classy Chris Nelson. After what happened to Al Greene last week, the best thing he can do is come out here and just beat the stew out of somebody to hopefully elevate himself back to the level he was on before he tapped out.
The bully Barry Darsow just egged him on, and unfortunately for Al Greene, he didn't realize discretion being the better part of valor. He apparently was manipulated by the bully, who is a classic manipulator. Now standing side headlock there, and he went out and got his mouth clean, just as he has just cleaned the cloth of classy Chris Nelson.
That was a real tackle right there. Two bodies colliding at full speed. One body going down and paying the price.
Dan, that's what WXO promised. That's what you have been promising, and so have I. It's about under-promising and over-delivering. It's bringing the action, the great, exciting action of professional wrestling, family-friendly pro wrestling, right into your living room.
At least every one of the competitors here has been sat down and told face to face, hey, if you're gonna wrestle here, if you're gonna work here, you better go out there and be pretty darn stiff, because we're not gonna play with it if it's not. We don't want any patty cake stuff going on here.
And Chris Nelson, as big a man as he is, oh, right over the top, he's right here in front of us. Right here, great camera work, and Al Greene, wait a minute. We got no beat. It was just call reaction. Is Al Greene walking out?
And make a note, we don't have any soft foam rubber pads around the ring. When you get tossed out here at WXO, you're going to hit some concrete, baby. You're going to suck some cement.
That's a very good point. And classic Chris Nelson is doing extremely well here against Al Greene, who did not, let us say, get the fans on his side early on. In fact, just the opposite. I am so excited about going to the Egg Dome in Tokyo here on this week's edition of WXO Wrestling.
I'm looking forward to seeing Johnny Ace and Michael Barton as they step inside the squared circle over there in the Orient, because it's going to be intense.
Well, let us say that Michael Barton, at the expense of some of the toughest wrestlers in this business, really made a reputation. So it's going to be very interesting, Stan, to see Michael Barton and Johnny Ace in tag team action.
Well, you got that right. A lot of tough guys who thought they were tough got knocked out cold, didn't they?
Oh, there's no doubt about it. They sure did. Move there, 1-2, almost a 3 on the big man, Chris Nelson. Al Greene got him over with a gut-wrench suplex.
In all fairness, though, wrestlers are wrestlers. We're not boxers. You put a padded glove on a wrestler, you might as well chain, because wrestlers are made to fight with their hands open to grab. That's what grappling is all about. So in all fairness to those guys, they got knocked out, but the guy had gloves on to do it.
That's a great analysis, Stan. Oh, nice boot there to the mush by classic Chris Nelson and Al Greene, and he does it again. Does Al Greene not learn? Does he need once, twice, or three times to be beaten? Now, the Irish whip into the far rope. Great maneuver by a man of his size. It's classic Chris Nelson. One, two, and almost got
it. Hook the leg. And you know what classic Chris Nelson should be doing? He should be working on the leg and the ankle of Al Greene. He should have done his homework. He got his gun.
Oh, wow. A portion of the sidewalk slam. Is that going to do
it's
it?
Over.
Yes, it is. Wow, the spine buster. And that is it. Al Greene victorious. You know, Stan, let's not forget what happened last week when a couple of fans got involved in the action. And I'm told, anyway, that we're going to try to get an update on what is going. In fact, we're going to go right back down. There they are.
You mean they're back?
They're back.
Maybe they're trying to get jobs. Who knows?
We'll try
they
to
are
find
big.
Out.
They're big.
We'll come back with more action on WXO Wrestling. Don't go away. The big man is... Oh, he's out. He's out.
It reminds me when I go into a rental car place, I always want to upsize to a larger vehicle. That's what Fred needs to do. At least get a Fleetwood Cadillac or a Humvee or something.
Play those kind of games with me? I'm here in WXO for one reason, and that is to be the best wrestler in WXO. You don't come down in the middle of my match and hit me in the head with a chair. You being from Minnesota know what I'm like, because that's where I'm from. When somebody hits me in the head with something like that, it comes back a lot harder on you. Mike Enos, you be ready for the bully.
Stan, as tough and as rough as Mike Enos is, I wouldn't want to be in his shoes or his wrestling boots with a guy like the bully on the warpath, essentially.
Well, these guys grew up together in Minnesota. You know, they were in Boy Scouts together. They were best friends. They had to camp out and all that kind of stuff. It's all out the window now, Cruz. Because he got hit in the head with a steel chair, and you got to pay somebody back for that. You just don't take that when you're on international TV and somebody comes out and causes you to lose your match because of it, bust your head wide open. I mean, it's going to be payback time, brother.
And a man who is familiar to some wrestling fans, young man by the name of Hack Meyers, he is going to be taking on, and listen to this, the Black Nature Boy. If anybody knows the Nature Boy, it's you, Stan Lane.
Well, I was trained by the Nature Boy, the only person to be personally trained by him, but it certainly wasn't this Nature Boy, I can tell you that right now.
Yeah, let's repeat that. Let us repeat that for emphasis. The Nature Boy, Ric Flair, personally trained just one wrestler in all of pro wrestling, and it was Sweet Stan Lane, the Black Nature Boy from Jacksonville, Florida, to take on Hack Meyers. Hack Meyers, a real veteran, the Black Nature Boy. He's trying to make a name for himself, and so is everybody here in WXO Wrestling.
I wonder if the Black Nature Boy is a master of the figure four leg lock as well. We'll have to find out.
All right, a little bit later, we will take a look, the first look ever at our new broadcast. broadcast colleague by the name of Jennifer Hart. I know that we're looking forward to that. Standing side headlock here by Hackmeyer. Big man.
I know I am. I'm sorry, backstage.
Oh, absolutely. As is WXO Wrestling here from Lakeland, Florida. Nice head fake there. Oh, beautiful drop kick there by the Nature Boy.
You know, you really get a sense of the impact that the body's taking. You're sitting down here at the ringside. As great as it is on TV, make your
hook. The hook. Flying cross body block at the Black Nature Boy almost. You're right, Stan. You can really feel it. You can see the sweat fly.
Make your plans to come out and see it live when it comes to your town, your city, your town. Because let me tell you something, as great as it is on TV, it's even better in person. You can actually feel the impact, the reverberation of those bodies as they slam against the mat.
Nice power slam. Recovered here by Hack Myers and almost a three. It's been a great hour so far, and still the question is, those fans that we saw from last week, and we saw them stand outside the office of the commissioner, you got to wonder, are they just trying to be able to buy a ticket to get back? Have they been banned for life? Are they trying to be wrestlers? Or is DiBiase going to press charges against them?
Well, you know, who knows? You know, what I'm thinking, maybe they got arrested. They went before a judge, and the judge told them, you know, if you go back down there, and you apologize to the commissioner, maybe they'll let you back in. But, hey, as big as they are, they obviously work out. You got to know that they're probably going to be arrested.
That's a very good point. And I'll tell you, Ted DiBiase has said, hang on, one, two, and no, almost a three on the Nature Boy by Hack Myers. Ted DiBiase in the first week here in WXO Wrestling. In fact, it was last week. Wait a minute. The roll from behind.
Oh,
wow. Nice maneuver. He said, it doesn't matter who you know. It's what you know and what you can do in the ring. Maybe he'll give him a chance.
Maybe he will. Hey, you know, maybe they are restless at some places. I haven't seen them. There's millions of guys out there.
Absolutely.
I'm seeing guys on the internet who are wrestling that I've never heard of. I mean, they're in their backyard. They're doing their own show. So these guys may be wrestling. Who knows?
Nice reverse chin lock there by Hack Myers on the Nature Boy. Let us remind you that the commissioner, Mr. Ted DiBiase, says he's not just the CEO, he is the CFO. And he also reminds everybody, you reap what you sow. And the buck stopped with him. He's trying to make his mark stand and clearly trying to say, I'm Ted DiBiase and I'm in charge.
You were hitting him up for a raise over there.
I'll tell you, he is the CFO, the chief financial officer, as well as the CEO. So if you need a raise, he's the man to go to.
Hey, this guy's got more toys than toys are us. I'm talking boats, planes, cars, motorcycles.
Nice flying forearm there by the Nature Boy. He set up Hack Myers extremely well, and now he goes up onto the third rope. He is going to fly. Great camera action. Misses big. Wow.
If it landed that, he'd probably go, woo!
You know, that's a nice point. A version of the rude awakening. And now, Hack Myers with a 1-2. This should be it.
Oh, yeah, the late and great Rick Rude. God bless you, buddy.
Absolutely.
This Hack Myers is a big man. He's not your athletic, like your bodybuilder type of guy. He's just there. He's thick.
I think, Stan, as we see in wrestling, that is what is really so impressive is that, oh, you don't have to be a pretty boy. You don't have to, oh, man, a nice elbow there to succeed in pro wrestling. You've got to be able to get it done, and Hack Myers can get it done in the ring.
Well, that's what makes it so diversified, professional wrestling. You've got guys that come from all schools. I mean, you got your amateur, your hardcore wrestling. You have your submission wrestling. You got your bar fighters. I mean, anything goes.
And Commissioner DiBiase has said anything and everything will go, and it is you will succeed on merit. This is a meritocracy. It's not all about political connections.
And what I like so much, Chris, it's not going to be an aristocracy because Ted DiBiase has been around a long, long time, and he gives guys a fair shake.
And two guys getting a fair shake, Hack Myers and the Black Nature Boy, and they are really going at one another.
Well, it's been nonstop action, but speaking of action, you know what? I like the tag team action. That's what I love.
Well, there's a lot more tag team action coming up this hour, isn't there?
Well, you got that right, Cruz. The Bodies and the Breakers, and these guys get it on bar the door.
Absolutely. We are looking forward to more tag team action, more individual competition on WXO. We have begun this new year with a new wrestling promotion, and we are so excited to be here at the very beginning. And that's not just a choke. That's a grab of the larynx.
That's not a choke. That's a blatant choke.
That's a good point. And Hack Myers and the Black Nature Boy, and it seems so strange to say that, but I'll tell you. If you want to emulate somebody, the Nature Boy is the guy. Wait a minute, something is going on in the back.
And the beast, the beast. The beast is going to have another feast, maybe.
Al, you got to get out of here. You wouldn't believe your buddy Severn. He's in the ring right now. You better show him
Cooley. Oh, an armbar.
The armbar, he's got him.
Oh, God, come on.
Look at the intensity Chris Cruz on the face of Dan Severn, the Beast. This got scary.
Last week, the
Al
Beast
Green's
made
coming.
A thing. What is
not again? Did he learn a lesson?
Has Darsow egged this guy on again? Oh, he speared him.
Double leg down.
A submission hold. He locks the ankle again.
Oh, Al Green's tapping. That'll blow your knee out in seconds right there.
Does he never learn? All right, the WXO debut of Mean Mike Enos, and later, our first look at our lovely broadcast colleague, Jennifer Hart, in a moment on WXO Wrestling. Cruz and Sweet Stan Lane and Stan, Dan Severn has really shocked this crowd.
Well, he continues to stretch ligaments and stretch tendons. He put that Kimura leg bar on poor Al Green again, and brother, he was going to Tap City one more time.
You gotta wonder, did Al Green not learn last week not to mess with a beast? Apparently not.
Maybe that's why he wears a mask. He's so hard-headed.
That's a very good point. All right, we're gonna see the bully, Barry Darsow, in action. And I have to tell you, between he and Mike Enos, so much bad blood and so unfortunate. It all began with a miscommunication last week, and we're going to see the bully now in action.
Well, he's going up against this guy right here, Pat Powers, who's no small fry. He's got to go 280.
You know, what I find fascinating here about WXO Wrestling is we seem to be bringing in guys that you've never heard of in some cases, the stars that they have heard of, but even the guys we haven't heard of are so impressive, like this guy, Pat Howard, who's taking it to Enos. Look out! Freaking outs are almost landed right on his head, on up.
Well, Mean Mike Enos is bigger than ever. You know, I wrestled against him with Mean Bloom years ago, and he wasn't nearly this big.
He's been wrestling since 1986. He's a product of the Minneapolis, Minnesota wrestling area. And this kid was trained by Brad Rankins, the Olympic wrestler. He can bench, check this out, 575 pounds.
Boy, you mentioned the name Brad Rankins. I'd love to see Brad Rankins go up against Dan Severn in a total shoot. That'd be great.
Absolutely. A woman had powers with a roll from behind, a kick out by those powerful legs there of Mean Mike Enos. TH National Powerlifting Champion, and this referee himself is getting a workout. I gotta tell you, Stan, I don't think Enos thought he would get this type of competition from Pat Powers.
Enos hadn't even had a chance to get his tank top off. Powers was all over him from the get-go because he knows if he beats a guy like Mean Mike Enos, hey, his rep thing's very set here, the big show. He moves up the ladder, and that's what it's all about. When you're starting out, you gotta take each step, each rung of that ladder, and make your way to the top.
The Irish with the reversal. Nice power slam there by Enos. He rocks the joint. He's 6'2", 285 pounds, and this guy is power-packed.
Looks like a big pumped-up pumpkin up there, black and orange.
Well, you can say that. I can't. Still to come. We've got more tag team action, and we wonder, is Dan Severn going to make another appearance here? Oh, and Enos unceremoniously jumps Pat Powers. Does dumping ever occur other than unceremoniously outside the ring? I didn't think so. It's so dangerous. There are no pads today.
No pads and nothing on that steel retaining barricade there. Those fans better back up. I hope we don't have another case of two big muscle heads jumping in on the action again.
Oh, no, look out for the barrels.
Look out, kid.
Man. They are literally right now. No.
Easy.
Look out. Oh.
Hang in there, Cruz. I'll take care of you, buddy.
It's going to be good, Stan.
Hey, this is not a Spanish announce desk here. He throws him back to the ring at Pat Powers. You take care of me. Why did you run when he came at me? Thanks a lot. I'll take care of me.
I told the guy, no moss.
Yeah, I don't think he understood that. Mean Mike Enos, as we said, 6'2", 285. I'm about 5'6", and 130. What am I going to do? Oh, man.
Pile driver.
And that's going to do it for Pat Powers. One. Oh, come on. At some point, referee, use your discretion and stop this match.
You think Enos is trying to send a message to his former best friend from childhood? What do you think?
Well, either that or he's remembering what happened with Barry Darsow. And again, let me remind you, Darsow and Enos, for a long time, the best of friends. It was a miscommunication. Now look at this power move. I can't believe he's going to try this.
And these people are hungry. It's like the old thumbs up, thumbs down, back in the old days, the Christians. Beat him to the lions, Enos.
This is what's going to happen. This is incredible strength. As we said, the teenage national powerlifting champion, and Powers is catapulted across the ring.
I love it. Oh, my. Somebody could get hurt, Cruz. I think that somebody already has, and his name is Pat Powers. Wow, Enos is power pass. And here he goes again. Look out, fans. Man. Oh, look. This Darsow.
Hey. Woo.
Have a cold one, bud.
It's just never going to end.
Wow. Darsow has come out of nowhere, the bully, and he has clocked Enos.
And the referee's making the count.
And that's it. I've always told him, do not drink beer during your match. Well, Pat Powers has won. Well, a big victory and totally unexpected. And I got to tell you, once again, it's all because of miscommunication, Stan. And it's real unfortunate what's going on with the bully. The bully and Mean Mike Enos, as we said, the best, the closest of friends. And this has started last week just because Barry Horowitz, he hit Enos. Enos hit the bully, and it's a miscommunication. It's got to stop.
Hey, I've told you before, the bully is the consummate bar fighter, and you saw he bought an ice-cold beverage out there, and he gave it to his former best friend, and brother, it was all over Stud City.
You know, I've never claimed to be handsome, but this man is sweet. But if you want to see something beautiful on camera, you're going to see it. You know it. Jennifer Hart coming up.
I like her.
Our broadcast colleague is going to join us
Angia.
For the first time. Angia, you're right, ever here on WXO Wrestling. We'll take a very quick break. A lot of action still to come.
That's my hair.
It looks great on WXO Wrestling.
Beyond huge, 6'8", 401 pounds, I'm told. He wears a size 16 shoe.
And he has finally gotten out of that little car that he arrived at the arena at. That was a little bit embarrassing. And we are going to see, for the first time, our broadcast colleague, Jennifer Hart.
She is so sweet.
And she is ready, and she's going to talk now to the Dominator, Fred Ottman. As we said, he's 6'8", 401, the tiny little Jennifer Hart.
Hi, everybody. I am Jennifer Hart with WXO Wrestling. Woo! And I have the huge, you're huge, Fred, the Dominator, Ottman. Woo! Fred, I understand you had a tough time today. You had a bad day.
Bad day? Bad day? We'll talk about bad days. I'm late to the building. I'm in my convertible. I get stuck. The door locks don't work. The steering wheel won't move. I look at guys. I'm screaming. Somebody comes over. They help pull me out of things. I'm out of line. And I'm here for WXO. And I'm excited, mother.
All right. Yeah. Woo. I got people here. You had a tough time getting out of your car. Why don't you get a bigger car?
I was a little kid. I wanted a sports car. I grew. The car stayed small. But the bottom line is I'm having fun. I'm excited being here with WXO. It's extreme. I love it. I'm excited. I'm only more excited being here or being next to you. But the bottom line is, this is where the tough action is. Grassroots. It's not who you know, how much makeup you wear, how pretty you are. It's how big, fat, nasty you are. And that's right. I'm nasty. And that's all these people need to know. My image is, I've wrestled all over the world. The toughest competition there is, and here's daily in WXO. The top guys are coming one by one by one, and I'm looking forward to it. Nobody's ever slammed me. I've got an open invitation. You want some of me? Look at this ugly face. I'm ready.
That's right. I couldn't have said it better myself. Back to you, Chris.
Well, Stan, Jennifer Hart was worth waiting for, our newest broadcast colleague here at WXO Wrestling. You've been smiling a lot.
Looking good.
Yeah, she really was. And also looking good, the Bodies and the Heartbreakers, Apollo and Adonis, along with the beautiful Gia. And the question is, why these two teams hate each other so much, Stan?
Well, it's pretty obvious to me that they're both young and tag teams. They both hit the gym, you know. They want to look good. They want to get some hot dates. Probably with Jennifer.
Tag team action and a whole lot more, including surprises, as always, coming up. So don't go away as we can stand lane. And now we're going to hear some comments from a man in Japan. In fact, he's still there. We'll be seeing him in a few weeks on WXO. It's Johnny Ace.
Johnny Ace, man in Japan. I'm in Tokyo right now, and all that I ever hear about is this WXO. What does the X stand for? I don't know. I don't care. but I'm coming to kick some butt. On the internet, the media, the press, they keep saying, Johnny, are you going to the WXO? And the answer is obvious. Yes. If you don't got it, get it. If you don't get it, figure it out.
Well, Stan, I'll be honest with you now. I have no idea what that means. Some kind of a movement that Johnny Ace apparently says is going to take place here in WXO Wrestling.
Well, I remember in the old days, Johnny Ace had more moves than X-Lax, but the movement
of WXO Wrestling, Chris Cruz, along with Sweet Stan Lane, nobody better to call tag team action than my partner, Stan Lane. We've got Ken Resnick, our broadcast colleague, Jennifer Hart, and we're going to have the bodies against the Heartbreakers, Stan.
And let's not forget about Miss Gia. There she is. Hello.
And Miss Gia, along with Apollo and Adonis, the Heartbreakers. And there is also, you got a question, what is going on with Adam Pearce? Is he a Heartbreaker wannabe?
Well, you know, can you blame him? I mean, these guys are on their way to the top here. Not only are they in great shape, not only do they wrestle just like a well-oiled machine, but they got this beautiful Gia who, I tell you what, she's beautiful, but she does some hard negotiations. Because I saw her talking to Mr. DiBiase earlier, saying, I want some tag team championship matches for my boys.
Well, she is certainly a compelling figure. Let us definitely say that. It is the Heartbreakers, Apollo and Adonis, as they take on the body. Great tag team action here on this, the historic second week of WXO Wrestling. And the bodies, they have really made a very quick
entrance. Look out,
Gia. And look out, ring announcer. This has got to be hot and heavy right here on WXO Wrestling.
Well, this feud has been building up, and now it's starting to boil over. The first week, we saw these two tag teams face off, and it was really, I mean, hitting by the door. But now, it seems like the tippers have finally flared.
That's a very good point. And the bodies, I think they know what Apollo and Adonis can do. It's not going to be clean wrestling. The fact is, they're cheaters. And Apollo and Adonis go down. Oh, man, beautiful series. Great chain there. And the bodies, with authority, have taken control of this match.
Well, they certainly have. They've obviously put their heads together this past week. They realized what they did wrong the first time, and they're going to try to correct the problem this time. And this time, hopefully, for their sake, they'll get a win.
As we said, we are wondering what the deal is here with Adam Pearce. Adam, earlier, in fact, on WXO in this series of programs, teamed with Tommy Rogers. So maybe he is, as we said, a Heartbreaker wannabe. Who knows?
Well, he's got a great partner in Tommy Rogers. I mean, Tommy Rogers knows all about tag team wrestling and, of course, singles competition. So Mr. Pearce would be well advised to stick with what he's got, not run around and want to be a mark with this tag team right here.
I've heard that word before. I'm not quite sure what it is. Does that mean that I'm a mark?
Just look up the dictionary, Bruce.
I will do that. All right. We still got some action from the Egg Dome to come in the coming weeks. Here on WXO Wrestling, that exciting conclusion of the match featuring Michael Barton and Johnny Ace in tag team wrestling. Now the standing side headlock here, the body over on Adonis.
Oh, you got to constantly be aware of where your shoulders are at all times. If you get lackadaisical and let those shoulders touch the mat, that referee begins his count. This referee is right down there. We got some great referees here in WXO.
It's really been exciting the past couple of weeks, and we are looking to WXO to really change and revolutionize pro wrestling family-friendly. Nice attempted a hip toss of reversal there by the bodies on Adonis. Nice arm drag. Shades of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And again, gets it over.
Well, we talked about going back to basics, not only in the ring as far as your hold, but going back to basics in the entire wrestling industry, Chris, because I think it's gone as far as it can to trash its way. You got to come back to what got you there. That's good basic competition.
And we can't emphasize enough the words of the commissioner and CEO and CFO of WXO Wrestling, Mr. Ted DiBiase, that he's going to give everybody a fair shake, that if you can do what you need to do in the ring, even if you're not politically connected, beautiful look there at Gio a moment ago, you are going to get a chance to rise all the way to the top. And how strange and foreign that is in wrestling.
Yeah. And WXO, Mr. DiBiase, I'm not going to concentrate on just the veterans. I'm not going to concentrate on the newcomers. They're going to get a good mix, an all-around mix. Oh, so get the best competition. Not only the guys who know what to do in the ring, but guys who are learning. And I like that because we need sometimes these older guys to move over, give the young guys a chance.
I don't think I could have said it better. I know thousands of people, millions of people have felt that same way, and we're giving the fans what they want. And as we said, it is wrestling you can watch with your children without being embarrassed by it. And that is a real shift, a seismic shift in professional wrestling. Now in comes it to Apollo. There it is. He attempts to do so. Nice switches here by the body stand. It looks like they've learned.
Well, you know, we just talked about them doing their homework. They certainly did. They took a page out of the other tag team's playbook there.
And Gia is none too pleased. I don't think she appreciates what the fans have to say, although the fans can't seem to take their eyes off this beautiful woman. And you know what else, Stan? You can't seem to take your eyes off her either.
Well, Chris, you know, my eyes are darting back and forth. I'll admit that.
But I'm watching the action, too. Oh, nice knee. There by Adonis here on WXO Wrestling. Man, you mentioned earlier, this guy's got no body fat.
What's your sign?
I think her sign when it comes to you might be stopped, but I'm not sure.
Ref just yield.
Double team there on the body. See the elevation. Man. And now an attempt at a switch, and here comes the double teaming that Apollo and Adonis, the Heartbreakers, do, unfortunately, so well.
Play it in there, boys.
You like the action, you've got to. Right here on WXO, we are ringside, coming at you from beautiful Lakeland, Florida, as we continue this new era in professional wrestling.
We told them to get stiff, and they get stiffer each and every week. That's the way we like it here at WXO.
A version there almost of the camel clutch by Apollo on the body.
Well, this move right here not only impedes the breathing, but it puts tremendous strain on the lower back, the lumbar area. And I tell you what, it's extremely uncomfortable. Now, if he pulled this gentleman's arms up above the knees, it's even more intense.
In the weeks to come, more from the Egg Dome in Tokyo, and we no doubt will see more of Gia, more of Jennifer Hart, and certainly more of the great action of WXO Wrestling. What was that from Adonis? Adonis knew exactly what he was doing in the switch, and now goes right back to that camel clutch-like move. Gia is very happy about that. In fact, she's very happy about just about everything when her team is winning.
Big mistake by the bodies. I mean, they've seen it time and time again over the years in wrestling. When you have a problem, don't step inside the ropes and talk to the ref. That just makes it worse. Stay on the outside and voice your complaint.
That's a very good point. That's Adonis now with the Irish whip into the air rope. And again, lifts the knee, and Adonis goes right for the other body, and he gets him too. And these bodies, they've got a lot of, certainly a lot of fire, but Stan, it looks like your inexperience is working against them.
Well, it's such a seven, they're a little green. There's another term that we've heard so many times, but hey, it's a fact of life. But they'll learn from this experience, and they'll get better from it.
That's a very good point as well. Reversal there by the bodies on Apollo. He's laying in those forearms, making him sicker. The Irish whip into the dome. High knee in the mush, and this kid could be out.
Well, that'll send you right here, Dennis.
Drops the elbow, 1-2, and a kick out there. And here comes again the switch here on WXO Wrestling. It's Apollo and Adonis, and they're going to get their way again.
Well, let's remind the fans that if we're tuning in for the first time in tag team competition, you do have a four count to make the change.
And nice switch out there by attempt anyway by the bodies. And Adonis maintaining control along with Apollo on the body. There's a kick and there's the tag. It's hot. And in he comes and he lays out Adonis. And now Apollo gets a knuckle sandwich. A whip to the near rope. High back body drop.
And notice that his fist was balled up. He wasn't slapping anybody like we see on some other channels.
Another high back body drop. Yeah, you're right. Very good point.
Oh, you can hear it. You can hear the impact.
We are right here at ringside on WXO. Attempted a knee. Did he just? Yeah, he did get him. He grazed him. Now all four men are in the ring here. This has broken down, and the referee, if he didn't lose control earlier, has certainly lost control now.
You know, being here in Florida, the heart of Florida, the silly country, let me just say this.
I'd rather up here, six brawl has just broken out. Absolutely,
Gordon.
It looks like it. Wait a minute. We see something happening here in the... Oh, my God.
On his
right
in
his head.
Oh.
This could be... Now, this is Adam Pearce. This is the one we talked about who is like a heartbreaker wannabe. This is Adam Pearce. He's got... It's good camera work. He's already got a tag team partner in Tommy Rogers. Is he going after the Heartbreakers? Oh, my God. Going after the Heartbreakers.
Well, maybe he does want to be one.
One, two, and three. He's
count the bodies to win. Or maybe he's a bodies wannabe instead of a heartbreaker wannabe.
Well, you know, the kid's young. Maybe he doesn't know what he wants.
Well, Adam Pearce has helped the bodies defeat the Heartbreakers. And oh, look out! Adam Pearce! What is going on here, Stan? What is going on?
They didn't appreciate the help. They want to win on their own. They don't want some outside guy helping them get a victory.
A 21-year-old from Chicago.
Tommy Rogers, the tag team partner of Adam Pearce, has come in. It's another Pearce 6. And the bodies are out of here.
Well, they cleared the ring quickly.
Well, Tommy Rogers apparently realizing that Adam Pearce has gotten himself into a whole lot of trouble. Well, he wanted it. Adam Pearce, we thought he was a heartbreaker wannabe. Turned out to be a body wannabe. And Stan, the bodies didn't appreciate the help.
Well, they certainly did not. But you know what? Maybe the kid just wants to get some more TV time. I mean, think about it. He's only 21 years old. It's his first time on national TV. He wants to do whatever he can to get his mug on the screen.
I'm Chris Cruz for Sweet Stan Lane. Fans, we're going to see you next week with another great hour of exciting WXO Wrestling. Don't miss it. It's the new era in pro wrestling.